In this module of the Microsoft Teams tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to use the calls feature in Microsoft Teams. Now, this is the integrated phone system as part of the Microsoft Teams. You can use a soft phone, the application here on the desktop after clicking on calls, or you can use a physical phone in your office integrated with Microsoft Teams. Once we click here on calls on the left, notice that we have here the contacts option or the phone option. The phone option, this is the soft phone area. So you can search for an individual here, and I'm not going to do the searching for privacy reasons. You select the number and then press call, and then press call over here. Then Microsoft Teams is going to launch the dialer, and from there, notice that you have the microphone icon where you can mute it from here, or you can add additional participants, or put the call on hold, or transfer it, or park it, and so on. To hang up, you can simply click on leave. If you want to display the keypad, you can click on the keypad icon and simply punch in the numbers to dial or to change, to transfer, or things of that nature. So that's how you make a call using a contact. Now, to make a call by simply typing the number, enter the numbers in there, and then press call. Once you're done with the call, you can press leave, and it will close it. The call history will be displayed here in the center column. And if you want to categorize the missed calls, you click on missed, incoming, and voicemail, and so on. Or you can also filter them from the top right-hand side here under these three dots. On the right-hand side, you can select speed dials. You can select particular groups. You can create speed dial entries or list other favorite contacts that you want to call. On the bottom section, notice that there is this option for don't forward currently. That means that my phone currently has been configured to not forward it. So it's going to ring and ring. And then after so many non-responses, after so many rings, then it'll go to voicemail. But if I want to forward it to voicemail automatically, all you have to do is click on the drop-down where it says don't forward. And then you can select to forward it to voicemail. If you wanted to change additional settings related to forwarding, you click here under More Settings. And this is where you can specify how to handle the calls and how long it should be before sending the call to voicemail. Further down, notice that you have here how to configure the voicemail. And you'd click on this and follow the prompts for configuring the voicemail. Further down, under the ringtones area, you can specify the particular ringtones if a call is for you, or if a call is forwarded, or it's a delegated call, and you can preview those ringtones as well. Now, to get to those settings, you can go also here on the top right, under Settings, next to the profile icon, and click on Settings, and then click on calls all the way at the very bottom. If you like this video, please press like, subscribe, and then click on the bell icon.